Hi students, welcome back to our video lectures. In the last class or in the last video lecture, we have discussed about class B push-pull amplifier, and we have also derived its efficiency, and we have also gone through the maximum power dissipation in class B push-pull amplifier. Now in this lecture, we will try to discuss about the harmonic distortion that presents in class B push-pull amplifier. Let us go ahead with the harmonic distortion. And we know the two base currents that are present for both the transistors, and one transistor will be conducting for positive half cycle, another transistor will be conducting for negative half cycle, means that there will be a phase shift between the base currents present for both the transistors. Let us quote that the transistor 1 having the base current IB1, which is equal to IBM cos omega t, and the second transistor having a base current IB2 is equal to minus IBM cos omega t. This minus is representing there will be a 180 degrees phase shift between the transistor 1 and transistor 2 base currents. And correspondingly, the collector current expression for transistor 1 is given by, we have already gone through this equation in our earlier discussions. The collector current equation can be given by both DC component, which is represented with ICQ plus B0, and AC component, and we can see that the AC component is nothing but involving with the term cos omega t, or simply you can say cos theta. This entire term from B1 cos omega t and so on, all these are all AC components. Similarly, we have IC2, and let us substitute that IB2 in order to find this IC2. Now see this IB2, which is equal to minus IBM cos omega t, we can rewrite by removing this minus. Let us rewrite this cos omega t plus pi. We will get it as a minus cos omega t. Now we know that IC2, which is equal to ICQ plus B0 plus B1, instead of minus, we are just rewriting this omega t plus pi, B2 cos 2 into omega t plus pi, and so on. If you try to expand this, we will get it as ICQ plus B0 minus B1 cos omega t plus B2 cos 2 omega t minus B3 cos 3 omega t, and so on. This is the collector current for transistor 1, and this is the collector current for transistor 2. We know the load current, which is equal to the difference between the transistor collector current 1 and the transistor collector current 2, IC1 minus IC2, because both the currents are in opposite direction in the load. That's why we'll try to represent IL is equal to IC1 minus IC2. Just to substitute both IC1 as well as IC2. And we know that IL is nothing but we can quote it as a total collector current. And you try to simplify this equation, you will get it as all the DC components are gets cancelled with each other, and we are getting only the AC components. 2 into B1 cos omega t plus B3 cos 3 omega t plus B5 cos 5 omega t, and so on. If we identify this equation, we don't have any DC component at all. Means the DC power dissipation gets reduced. And we can identify only the fundamental frequency B1 cos omega t. Apart from that, these are all the harmonics we have. If we identify the remaining equation, we have only 3 omega t, 5 omega t, 7 omega t, 9 omega t, and so on. Means that the harmonics are reduced. Whenever the harmonic components are reduced, correspondingly, the harmonic distortion also reduces. We try to quote here in case of a class A B push-pull amplifier compared with the previous methods. Here the harmonic components are eliminated. Straight away we can quote the even harmonics are removed, and we have only the odd harmonics. As a result, harmonic distortion is reduced when compared with the previous methods. And we can quote the distortion because of third harmonic. D3 is equal to B3 by B1. Similarly, D5, this is the distortion due to fifth harmonic component, B5 by B1. We can easily quote that what is the total distortion or the overall distortion due to these odd harmonics, which is d is equal to, or percentage of d is equal to square root of d3 square plus d5 square plus d7 square plus d9 square plus d11 square and so on. Only we have odd harmonics that are going to present. And it is very much clear that compared with the previous class A power amplifier, in class B power amplifier, we have less harmonic distortion. Now, let us come to the next one. What are the advantages of this class B push-pull amplifier? These advantages are compared over majorly with respect to class A. And definitely the efficiency of class B is higher when compared over class A. Due to the transformer, the impedance matching is done. Reason, the transformer is having a low impedance. As a result, it can be able to deliver the maximum output across the load. That is one advantage. It provides a better impedance matching. And we have already seen in the previous equation, the total collector current where the DC components are gets cancelled. As a result, we don't have any DC component existing at the output side. And one more thing we have quoted in the distortion, which is a harmonic distortion. Even harmonics are gets eliminated. We have only the odd harmonics. As a result, the harmonic distortion also reduced in class B push-pull amplifier. See here, no power dissipation whenever there is no input signal. We know the power dissipation is because of PDC minus PAC. We know the basic equation is the difference between the DC signal and the AC signal. If you don't apply any AC signal, the power dissipation is going to be becoming equal to DC, but at the output side, all the DC components are gets cancelled. There is no power dissipation. That is one more advantage of class B push-pull amplifier. Now, come to what are the disadvantages we have with this class B push-pull amplifier. We need two center tap transformers. One is at the source side, another one is at the load side. Whenever you are trying to use the transformer, the size is going to be increasing, space occupying is also increases, cost is also going to increase. Because of using the transformer, we already know the major drawback, its frequency response is very, very poor. These are the advantages and disadvantages of class B push-pull amplifier. Now, move on to the second class B amplifier. So far we have discussed about push-pull amplifier. Now we will go through complementary symmetry class B amplifier. Why it is called as a complementary? Reason is, we are using two transistors. Both the transistors are complement with each other. One is a NPN transistor and second one is a PNP transistor. But in case of a push-pull amplifier, we are using both the transistors are of same type. Both might be NPN or PNP. We are not using one transistor as a PNP, another transistor as a NPN. We are going to be using both transistor 1 and transistor 2 are of same type in case of push-pull. But in case of a complementary symmetry, one transistor is PNP, another transistor is an NPN. That's why we call it as a complementary. But the basic working, they are going to be working in a symmetrical manner. That's why it is called as complementary symmetry class B amplifier or power amplifier. Now, let us see the basic diagram for complementary symmetric class B amplifier. We can identify one more difference here. Whenever you are trying to use NPN and PNP transistor, both requiring two different sources. NPN is requiring a positive VCC, PNP is using a negative VCC. This is one problem when we come to complementary symmetric class B amplifier, requiring two supplies. It is requiring two supplies. But see, the source signal is get supplied to both the bases at the same time. And the working principle is also very easy. Let us move on to one more here. Why it is we are calling it as a complementary? This is an NPN, another one is a PNP. Both two different types of transistors we are using. But symmetrically, we are trying to apply the signal to both the transistors with the help of two power sources, we call it as a symmetric method. And this is the basic diagram for complementary symmetry class B power amplifier. Now let us go on to the working. You try to apply a positive half cycle. This is plus. Anyhow, this is also going to plus. This is NPN, basis of P type. Here PNP, basis of N type. You try to apply a positive half cycle. Q1 is going to become on. Q2 is going to become off. Whenever Q1 is in on, and this is what is the current direction. Always from the higher potential towards the lower potential. This is what is the current direction for positive half cycle. Similarly, you apply a negative. Q1 is going to become off. Q2 is going to become on. Now, this is what is the direction. Compared to the negative, it will be treated as a zero potential. And this is what is the current direction. And it will flow towards the minus VCC. Now, we will code that with the diagrammatic fashion. This is for the positive half cycle what we have already quoted. You try to apply a positive half cycle. Q1 is going to be becoming on. Q2 becomes off. And this VCC, we have a current flow through RL. As a result, there will be a positive half cycle that is going to be existing because it will be treated as a plus and minus. And we have a positive half cycle. Anyhow, this transistor is off. It acts as an open circuit. And there will be no current in this Q2. You apply a negative half cycle. And this transistor Q1 is off and Q2 is on, and this is will be treated as a zero potential. Compared with the minus VCC, it is at a higher potential. Now this is what is the direction of current, and it will flow through this. Through this means this is becoming a plus and this is becoming as a minus. As a result, we will get it as a negative. This is what is the basic working of complementary symmetry class B amplifier, and this is what is the output we are getting. Positive half cycle, Q1 on, Q2 off. Negative half cycle you are getting across the load, that is due to Q1 is off and Q2 is in on condition. Let us move on to what is the mathematical analysis. Whatever the analysis we have done for the previous circuit called as a class B push pull amplifier, the same analysis is applicable for complementary symmetry class B amplifier. We no need to change any expressions. We can write all the expressions as it is. Now, what are the advantages for us when compared to our push-pull amplifier? We are not using any transformers at all. That is the first major advantage we have. We don't use any transformers in complementary symmetry. As a result, weight is less, size is less, cost is also reduced. And second one, here we are trying to use a common collector configuration. Impedance matching is provided. It is, we can see this. You are taking the output at the emitter. Whenever you are taking the output at the emitter, it will be called as emitter follower or common collector. That's why it is a common collector configuration. It provides a very good impedance matching. And in the previous case, we are using a transformer, and we know the one major drawback, frequency response is poor only because of the presence of the transformer. Now, in this method, in complementary symmetry class B amplifier, we don't have any transformer. As a result, frequency response is good compared with the previous method. Now, come to the disadvantages. We have already quoted the disadvantage. It is requiring two power supplies. One is a plus VCC and minus VCC. At the same time, we have a distortion called as crossover distortion. In the next class, in the next concept or in the next slide, we will discuss about what is exactly meant by this crossover distortion, how to eliminate this crossover distortion. Now, move on to what is exactly meant by this crossover distortion. We know whenever you are trying to apply a signal to the transistor, it is a practical transistor, and VBE is requiring is equal to 0.7 volts. Until that, the transistor will be remaining in off state. Now see, whenever the input is increasing at the base of the transistor, up to this point called V gamma, which is equal to 0.7, the transistor will be off. If the transistor is off, there is no output signal. That's why we quote it as a zero. at this point the transistor will become on, it acts as a short circuit. Then whatever the signal we have, that signal will flow from the input to the output. Again, it is below this V gamma, again the transistor will become off. From this duration up to this level, the transistor will be in the off state. This is for Q1. Similarly, for negative half cycle, transistor 2 is going to be on. Whether it is a transistor T1 or it is a transistor T2, any transistor is requiring VB which is equal to 0.7. And here also, up to 0.7, from the origin up to 0.7, Q2 is going to become off. Now see here, you try to look at this, it is not a pure sinusoidal. There will be some distortion whenever it is crossing from the positive to negative, negative to positive, again positive to negative. That's why the distortion is called as crossover distortion, and this crossover distortion is only because of the transistors that are present in the off state. In the next class, we will discuss about how to eliminate this crossover distortion, what are the different methods we have. That's it. Thank you.